Hello children, welcome to the digital class. As a part of ratio and application, today we will discuss the topic rate. Okay, now what is rate? If one quantity is compared to the other quantity, then we can say it as a rate. Let us take some examples. I bought apples at the rate of 120 rupees per kg. Here one quantity is in terms of rupees and the other quantity is in terms of kgs. Here we are comparing these two terms, two quantities. Now the cost of apples is compared to the quantity of apples. Okay, now let us take one more example. My father drives the vehicle with a speed of 60 km per hour. Here one quantity is 60 km and the other quantity is time taken, that is in hours. Means one quantity we are comparing with the other quantity. Okay, now here the word per can be replaced with this symbol. This is the symbol we are using here, this is the symbol, and above examples can be written in the symbolic form like this. Okay, now here see here 60 kilometers per hour, it is in the word form. If you convert it to symbolic form, it becomes 60 kilometers per hour. And one more example, it is 120 rupees per kg. If you write in symbolic form, it is 120 per kg. Okay, now other topic is unitary method. Okay, as the name suggests, unit means one. Means in order to find the required number of units, first of all we have to find the value of one unit. Then afterwards, we have to multiply that number with the required number of units. That was the definition. The method in which we first find the value of one unit and then the value of the required number of units is known as the unitary method. Means first we will find the value of one unit, then afterwards we will multiply with the required number of units. Now let us take some examples on unitary method. Here first question. A shopkeeper sells 5 tumblers for 30 rupees. What would be the cost of 10 such tumblers? Okay, since we are solving this problem by using the unitary method, first of all we have to find the value of one tumbler. Since it is clearly given that cost of 5 tumblers is equals to 30 rupees, now let us find the cost of one tumbler. Cost of one tumbler means 30 divided by 5, which is 6 rupees. Now the cost of one tumbler is 6 rupees. Now we have to find the cost of 10 tumblers, means 10 into 6, it becomes 60 rupees. Now let us solve one more question regarding the unitary method. Now see the second question. What is the cost of 9 bananas if the cost of a dozen bananas is given as 20 rupees? It's clearly given that cost of a dozen bananas, one dozen equals 12 items. Since the item is here banana, cost of dozen bananas means cost of 12 bananas is given as 20 rupees. Now we have to find the cost of 9 bananas. Okay, since we are solving this problem by using the unitary method, we have to find the cost of one banana first of all. Cost of one banana means 20 divided by 12, means cost of one banana is now 20 by 12 rupees. Now what we have to find, we have to find the cost of 9 bananas. Cost of 1 banana is 20 by 12, then cost of 9 bananas means 9 into 20 by 12. On calculation you will get 15 rupees. At last cost of 9 bananas is 15. Okay, now it's time of assignment work. As we know about the unitary method, all of you do this problem by using the unitary method. I will read the question once. If Kohli scores 100 runs in 90 balls, then how many number of balls he required to score 150 runs? Okay, you have to do this problem by using the unitary method. First find the one unit value, then afterwards multiply with the required number of units. Now direct proportion. Now it is the most important topic, that is direct proportion. Now what is direct proportion? Once I will read it, there are various situations in a day-to-day life when a change in one quantity leads to a change in the other quantity. What it means? If one quantity increases or decreases, then automatically the other quantity also increases or decreases. Such type of proportion is said to be direct proportion. Direct proportion. If one quantity increases or decreases, then automatically the other quantity also increases or decreases. Same thing happens, then only you can say it as the direct proportion. Okay, let us take some examples on direct proportion. Okay, let us see it. A shopkeeper sells 6x for rupees 30. Then what would be the cost of 10x? First, let us identify whether it is in direct proportion or not. Now, how to identify? Here, 6x cost 30 rupees. 6x, 30 rupees. 10x, what happens here? If the number of x increases, automatically the cost also raises, increases. Okay, now here 6 to 10, the number of x are increasing, automatically 30 also change, 30 value also increases. Means x are increasing, the cost is also increasing. Such type of proportion is said to be direct proportion. Okay, direct proportion. That only we wrote here. If the number of x increases, then their cost also increases. Then what we can say, they are in proportion. Now ratio of number of x is equal to ratio of their costs. Ratio of number of x. Ratio of number of x means 6x is to 10x. That is 6 is to 10. Now we don't know the cost of 10x. Let us take it as x. But cost of 6x is given as 30. In order to write in the ratio form, 30 is to x we wrote here. Already ratio of number of x is 36 is to 10, that equal to 30 is to x. Both are in proportion. Now what is the proportional condition? Product of extremes is equals to product of means. Now what are extremes and what are means? Here 6 and x are extremes and 10 and 30 are means. Now let us apply proportionate condition, that is product of extremes is equals to product of means. On further calculation, 6 into x equal to 10 into 30. On bringing this 6 to this side, it will become division. Now, on division, 6 ones are 6, 5 are 30. Now, x value becomes 50 rupees. Therefore, we can say that cost of 10x is equals to 50 rupees. Okay, now let us solve one more problem. Okay, both in unitary method as well as in direct proportion. Okay, here one more question is there, that is 20 kgs of rice is needed for a family of 4 members. How many kgs of rice will be required if the number of members in the house increases to 10? Once again, the same condition here. Here, 20 kgs of rice is there. Number of members are 4. Means for 4 members, they are consuming 20 kgs of rice. For 10 members, how much they will consume? Means if the number of members are increasing, automatically the quantity of rice will also increase. That in terms of direct proportion. Now let us solve this problem by unitary method first of all. Now what is unitary method? Already we discussed unitary method means first of all we have to find the value for 1 unit, then afterwards we have to calculate it. Now it is given that amount of rice required for 4 members is 20 kgs. It is given condition. Now, since it is a unitary method, first let us find the value for 1 member. Means amount of rice required for 1 member means 20 divided by 4. It is 5 kgs. Means quantity of rice required for 1 member is 5 kg. But what is the required condition here? We have to find the quantity of rice for 10 members. Quantity of rice for 1 member is 5 kg. Quantity of rice for 10 members means 10 into 5. It becomes 50 kgs. Okay, that is unitary method. Now, method 2, direct proportion. Already I discussed you. Now what is direct proportion? Here if the number of members are increasing, automatically the quantity of rice also will increase. That only we wrote here. If the number of members increases, the consumption of rice also increases. It means both are in direct proportion. Now ratio of members is equal to ratio of quantity of rice. Ratio of members means 4 members is to 10 members. That only wrote we here. 4 members is to 10 members. And quantity of rice is for 4 members they are consuming 20 kgs of rice. We don't know how many kgs of rice for 10 members. That's why we have taken it as x. Now once again they are in proportion. What is the meaning of proportion? Product of extremes is equal to product of means. Here extremes means 4 into x and product of means 10 into 20. That only we wrote here. 4 into x equal to 10 into 20. And bringing this 4 to RHS part, it will become division. On cancellation you will get 50 kgs. On cancellation you will get 50 kgs. Means amount of rice required for 10 members is equals to 50 kgs. Okay, now one more most important topic, that is percentages. Okay, ratios also appear in the form of percentages sometimes. Okay, now let us learn about the percentage and the various values in which we use them in our daily life. Most of the times we will use the percentages in order to compare the terms easily. Now, what is percentage? What is percent first of all? The word percent means per every 100. Per every 100 or per a 100. Now, we generally we use symbol for percentages. What is the symbol we use for percentages? This one. Now, let us take some examples here. Let us take some examples. Now, 1%, we have heard it so many times. What is 1%? 1% means 1%, we write it as 1% is nothing but 1 out of 100. 1 out of 100 means for 100 marks we got 1 mark, like that. 1 by 100. 1 by, if you convert into decimal form, we can write it as 0.01. Similarly, 27%. 27% means 27 out of 100. Means the total number of marks, if the total number of marks are 100, he got 27. Like that, we have to compare. Convert 27 by 100 into decimal form, that is 0.27. Similarly, 93% means 93 out of 100. If you convert into decimal form, it becomes 0.93. Okay, now most important. Generally, we use percentage in order to find profit and loss, discount, sometimes interest. For example, if you go to a shopping mall or something, you will ask the discount. They will say 2% discount, 3% discount. What it means? They are decreasing the value by 2%, 3%. Okay, now let us discuss these percentages on profit and loss. Okay, before discussing percentages on profit and loss, now we have to discuss what is profit and what is loss. What is profit? Okay, let us see one example here. A toy maker makes a toy for 50 rupees. And if he sells it for 75 rupees, does he get profit or loss? Means, the amount he is spending on the toy is 50 rupees and he is selling that toy for 75 rupees. Selling at 50 rupees and manufacturing cost becomes 50 and he is selling that item for more than manufacturing cost. Means he is selling for more money. Means here cost price of the toy is 50 rupees and the selling price of the toy is 75 rupees. Means he is selling that item for more money. Means here SP is greater than CP. Means whenever selling price is greater than the cost price, automatically he will get the profit. How much profit he is going to get here? See, actually, how much profit he is going to get? Actually, he is selling it for 75 rupees minus manufacturing cost is 50 rupees. Means 75 minus 50 is 25 rupees. Means at last he is getting the profit at 25 rupees. By this we can deduce the formula. What is that formula? Profit is equals to 75 rupees is nothing but SP. That one I wrote here, SP minus cost, 50 rupees is nothing but cost price. Profit equal to SP minus CP. This is the formula regarding profit. Okay, now let us discuss about the profit percentage. Now, by the above example, let us find the profit percentage of that item. How much he is getting the profit percentage? See here, for 50 rupees, he got 25 rupees profit. That only we find it here. The cost price is 50. Means for 50, he is getting 25 rupees profit. Now, in order to find the percentage, per every 100 we wrote it. Means per 100 rupees, how much he is going to get the profit? Now, profit percentage is equals to 100 into 25 by 50. Now I am writing 100 means 100 only, but what is 25 here? 25 refers to profit. That only I wrote on the top here. 100 into, in place of 25 I wrote profit, in place of 50 I wrote CP. In place of 50 I wrote. By this what we can conclude here? Profit percentage equals to profit by CP into 100. Similarly we can find other two formula, that is a loss formula as well as loss percentage formula. Okay, profit percentage. Then afterwards loss percentage, means percentages we can use in profit and loss. Similarly, we can use it in discount as well as interest also. Simple interest, compound interest, so many topics are there. We will see it in later. Okay, thank you.